And, you know, you wouldn't think Knoxville, Tennessee to be a hub of any sort of gothdom at all whatsoever.
It's the alternative crowd. It's where we belong, you know, and we congregate when we find each other publicly. And that happens to be at Temple.
And dress how you want, act how you want, and nobody blinks an eye.
And I want the misfit toys that I can totally hang out with.
When you're around people that truly don't care and are just being themselves, it's very infectious.
There's not too many other places you can go out and kind of experience what you're going to experience here.
It was the atmosphere. It was the music. It was about coming and being with people that are like-minded.
Especially in Knoxville, you've got, you know, country western clubs, you have college crowd, and that's about it. If you want anything more sophisticated or if you want anything that's more on the alternative edge, you're kind of screwed.
It's the only thing in Knoxville, probably even in all of East Tennessee, that caters to this type of music, like the industrial, the goth.
It's not a clique, it's not a club. It's the best way I can describe it as family.
I went and spoke to a nightclub that had nothing going on. You know, they were on their last leg. They were basically getting ready to close down. And I said, well, what if I come in here on a Saturday and bring a lot of friends? I'll provide the music, and you guys provide the drinks, and we'll just do our thing. And they said, sure, what do we got to lose? I mean, you know, we don't care. There's nobody here on Saturdays anyway. Sure, come on in. And we did right at 100 people that first night.
I was there the first night DJing. I was kind of a regular guy for, I don't know, the first 3 or 4 months.
In my opinion, definitely gives people that don't fit in anywhere else in Knoxville, don't feel like they have a quote-unquote home, a place to go, a place that they can be themselves.
Jay was able to talk to Terry and get the weekly event at the Electric Ballroom.
More people than not will say that the Electric Ballroom days were the heyday. That was the golden era or the silver age or whatever.
A weekly night for the crowd, where he actually used DJs who were members of the scene. And Jay offered that opportunity. And I started showing up early and practicing with the decks to the point where Jay actually asked me to start teaching the new DJs. And in that, I became the resident DJ for the night.
Give some chance for people who haven't DJed before, gives them a chance to spin.
I love to see the crowd dance. I'm like, I want to make them dance. I want to make them feel the music that I play.
I've had apprentice DJs who have gone on to other major cities. For me, it's all about the music. The music which I share with the people. And the people love the music, and therefore I am loved.
Involving the community with what's going on in Temple, that's been a lot of the success of what he's done here.
I mean, we have people that are 18, we have people that are 38. We have people who have an established career. We have people that are probably on the wrong side of the law. I would say if we could all have a common thread, it would be that maybe we just don't belong anywhere else.
The future, I hope, only has good things in store. I mean, nothing lasts forever, obviously. So, I mean, the fact that I can provide a place for people to go and have a good time, that's great. I hope it grows. I hope it gets better. I mean, every week, people come out and they have a good time and they see the family environment that we've got here. And so they keep coming out and it keeps growing and keeps getting better. Every club in Knoxville that supported this scene, at some point, you know, they do their run for 2 or 3 years, they close down, and everyone says, oh, you know, the Lava closed, oh, the Mercury closed, you know, the scene's going to die now. It never does. You can't kill the family. It just has to change. You know, it just has to evolve a little bit. It's not going to go away anytime soon, that's for sure. Those bonds aren't going to go away easily. They'll be around for a while.
Evolution is the key to continuation.
I've been very accepting of different types of venues, different types of crowds. You know, the gay community quite a bit. Hot Rods, when that was Hot Rods, it was a gay bar, but they were more than happy to let us come and play in their yard.
It has reinvented itself many, many times, but it still has the core spirit of being an alternative place for alternative people to go.
One constant is there's always change. You just see that this thing's alive.
An experiment that is never going to be over. I don't think there's a formula for Temple. I think it's an endless ongoing experiment.
This is good. If it wasn't good, it wouldn't have been here for 10 years. Well, that and Jay's back-breaking work to keep it. I mean, there were days where it wasn't going to be around.
If Jay Harris is alive, I think Temple will continue.
By mixing the old wave and the new wave, sometimes you can create your own wave, and I think that's what the staff here is like.
Got the Gothic Gallery that comes and sets up and shows their art, and they also sell art. It's a great opportunity for people who actually market things to this scene.
The same thing goes with our vendors, you know. These are people who are active in the community. They are part of us. You see the person who actually created this thing. I've never seen a more appreciative group of artists.
It's a great opportunity to get out there and sell things that you don't necessarily see everywhere else, and it gives the people here a chance to buy stuff that they wouldn't find anywhere else.
It's actually, they're supportive. They've reached out to local artists, to film, to comedy, you know, to musicians, and I can't. Jay Harris did a landmark decision by keeping this thing open-ended.
We have like 200-300 guests on a Saturday night. Maybe 95 of those are actual regular temple goers. The others are brand new people. And it's a good thing.
If you're a redneck, hippie, you know, preppy, everybody always comes here and has a good time.
It's nice to have an outlet where I don't feel out of place. Regardless of my age, regardless of how I have dressed, regardless of everything, it's very inclusive. And one of the few places where you are not judged for coming out and just enjoying yourself and having a good time. So that's something that I valued 10 years ago, and that's something that I value today.
And I think that's why we've been here for 10 years and why I don't see it stopping anytime soon.
It's always been a great time, and I look forward to 10 more years.
All these dance nights in Knoxville come and go. We're the freaks and the weirdos, and here we are still going strong 10 years later.
I hope we're around for another 10.
Does it have 10 more? I don't know. I don't know how long our livers are going to last, but would I like to see 10 more? Yeah, I'd stick around.
Thanks, Jay.